So welcome back. In this tutorial, we are going to create roof. So if you are not watching the previous video on how I created this plan and how I annotated everything from dimension to bringing the text into each room. So try as much as possible to watch the previous lesson. Go to the playlist and check the Revit tutorial. So, and make sure you subscribe to our channel because we continue in this series to the very end, and a lot of more video on daily basis we are bringing. So subscribe for us so that we continue bringing video to you on daily basis. So now, the next thing to do here is that we want to create roof on this particular building, because there's no way we can create elevation if we not have a unique roof on the building. So click on the shadow of this so that the graphics will not be slowing down your system. So the first thing to do now is to create on roof. Click on roof by footprint. On this, click on pick line. At the pick line, change the offset because of the heave of the roof to 600. Then start placing them one after the other on the wall. The uniqueness are going to be snapping to each place. Good. So you put the lines all around the building in that manner. So zoom out. Any area that you see that is lagging, fix everything. Remember, you have to have a closed loop of line when you are in the sketch mode, because when you are in sketch mode, you are going to see this particular pink line all through. So make sure that you toggle around and trim everything to the last. There should be no intersecting line. Every line must join together. So after you have done with this, click on cancel, click on cancel. On this particular one, make sure that your roof are in level 2. Click here, say level 2. Now, so what you need to do now is just to click finish and see how the roof is being placed. To say no, do not attach, because there is some condition being attached to it. So click on do not attach. So go to level 2. Probably you may not see it. Okay, it's there, but it's not visible enough. So go to your site plan. This is how you find the complexity of your roof. Do not let this complexity confuse you. It's just a way of which the revenue. Now, one thing I see here is that the slope arrows are all falling into one direction. So pay attention, because everything just have to fall according to the slope of the roof. So click on the roof here now. The first thing to do is to click on edit type. So you want to change the property of the roof. And with the property we want to change here is from the structure. Click on structure, click on roof tiles. Let it load. So now, after it assembles the view for you, be quick now. Now, so you have already selected roof to the graphic. In your graphics now, foreground, if we're going to work on surface, click on this. So you use model, click on model, then you come select any vertical. You can decide to create new one, create new. So you call it roof vert. That's roof vertical. That's new. You can decide to change any name. I'm using parallel line. So you click on this and say angle 90 degree. on this particular one, it's too big for me. I just want to use something like 55 millimeter spacing. So I say click OK, click OK, click OK. You see this one, I say click OK, then apply. Did you see? From the apply, everything changed back to the arrow force according to the slope of the. So that's how you do your roof. Now the next roofing system we want to do is that roof cannot be like this. Roof just must just have a rich cap so that every aspect of it is going to be thick. So make sure you watch this video to the end, and importantly, subscribe to this channel so that we give you a unique design. So now what you need to do next is to go to any of the elevation that you know that okay, you can see the roof accurately. Very low, it's because of the shadow, it's affecting the gravity. So very peak. So at this point now, what you do is to select this and say copy from here, copy to the next. Sorry. Because of the interruption of the electricity. Now you copy to the next. So go back to your site plan, because you want to remove, you want to create we want to create roof ridge cap on this particular roof. So what you do is to click on the vertical, select the above roof and say start picking points. So what I used to do, I used to use 80 millimeter as a offset point for every ridge cap I create. So click here, select, click, select, click, select, click it, select the opposite. So that's how you walk around the same thing outside around this place. You only do the ridge cap, the peak of the roof. That's what you do. Do not do the slope. Do not ever do any gutter side. So you identify the peak through the center edges. Wherever you find it that it has connection with the edge like this of the building, that is what you trace out and do everything accordingly. So do not do the one that fall in between two lines of the edge. So any line that fall at the angle, peak angle like this, that is where you pick your ridge cap from. So when you look at it now, you have selected all the ridge cap in the center. So pick and select everything around. So now what you will do is to trim everything so that there won't be intersection of any line when you want to click your, you want to conclude the sketch part of this joint. Remember what we use create vertical to create this one. It's not that we are creating another roof. Immediately after we copy one roof on the other, we are creating a vertical on the top roof. So that is going to give an opening space. So you can use it to create opening in the roof as well. If you have some design that okay, you want to create opening in them, so you use the same method to create opening there. Always watch all of our video to the end so that you'll be able to understand the trick and the uniqueness of what you are creating. So click, select everything like that, so to trim up. So if you have, if you are not clear of whether there's some line that you have not aligned, you can first click on finish. You can click on finish. If it gives you, it will going to tell you that there is some line that are intersecting. So from there, you see some line change to orange, like this color. Now there is intersection from it. So if you have it like that, so it tell you that you say continue. That is the trick that we are talking about, that you almost always follow. A lot of people will get quit and make mistakes. So you click like that and you say finish. So after that, they are showing you this is the perfect roof that we have created here. Zoom to Vit. So now from here, you cannot duplicate this side view and say rename. You can say, okay, no, don't rename, just for duplicate it with what you can just duplicate with all detailing. That's if you have any annotation like dimension of free, but let me just duplicate normal. So you duplicate only the model and I rename this particular one, say rename and say roof plan. So that's it. So I rename it now, it's roof plan. So it's different from the site plan. This is the roof plan that I've created. So go to your crop region, then make sure that you put the roof in the middle of your of the crop, and after that now you say crop the field, so all the elevation markers, everyone disappear. You can decide to hide this crop region as well and say click fit. So this is the uniqueness of your roof plan. So now, if you want to create some little bit of annotation that the roof, you show them the slope arrow, just go to annotate and click on the fill region, click fill. So here now, you draw a triangle, then you close it. So as you're done with this one, come here, just pick it and say, deposit around this particular place. So here now you click on finished. As you click on finish, it's already on a normal solid black line, so mirror it, so I'll be able to use it in another part. So use your arrow key to change it. So you can do the same thing around for every other one. So here you click on copy, put it here, then you click on rotate. You get what I'm saying now? So you rotate it to something like angle 90 degree, adjust it, bring it up. So you can do the same thing for heavy arrow that fall to this direction. Copy and paste. So copy and paste anywhere you see that the arrow falls down to straight up like that. That is how you do. So here now I want to mirror so that you go to the back side. So I've done that now. So already here, first here, you get it. So the same thing here, you click on copy and you paste it around here. So you do all around like that for all your buildings. So click and fit. That is how you create roof plan in Revit system. So kindly subscribe to our channel for the next